What's up, everyone? Welcome back to Spoiling Movies. My name is Chris, and it's time for spooky season to begin. I've got a movie for you this week. I'm going to do a review. I'm going to do spoilers in the review. I'm going to tell you things that happen about the film and how I feel about them. This week's movie is called Incubus. It was given to me by my buddy Chakra. What up, Chakra? Before I get started talking all about the thing, I'll give you my pre-spoiler opinion. It was bad. It's kind of a bad movie. It's got redeeming qualities. It's got Tara Reid in it. It's not a selling point. It's one of those, like, straight-to-Redbox types. You know, like certain celebrities that get into these low-budget weirdo movies. It has really, really good set design. And there's, yeah, maybe things here and there are okay. It's just, overall, it's not good. it's an obviously just low budget bad movie, and certain things don't make sense. So I would not recommend this movie unless you like really, you know, like B, C level goofball movies. Now on with the spoiling of the movie. It starts with a scientist woman running from a scientist man in this weird-looking facility. They're, like, underground. There's, like, hallways and pipes and shit. They're wearing lab coats, so it kind of looks like they're scientists. He's got a crowbar. She's got a key and a screwdriver. And the opening shit kind of just does really bad-looking flashbacks that show some dude stabbed in the eye with a screwdriver. So as the sequence went on, I was like, all right, so she stabs him in the face with a screwdriver. She's got a key, and that key is gonna do something later in the movie, I'm sure. And it keeps cutting back to this guy that looks like the bad Deadpool from Wolverine Origins. So I'm gonna call him Bad Deadpool. You'll know what I'm talking about when I put him on screen. So these teens are on a group trip somewhere, and they flipped their van. That's when we meet these kids. They need to go find people. They can't get a cell signal, so they're trying to. They're like, we can't stay with the van. We gotta go find people to, you know, help us. This movie feels very foreign. There's a lot of ADR, I believe it's called, where they just kind of dub over some of the characters' voices as they're talking. And I could tell by the accents, like, some of them were foreign. The director was Anya Camilleri. So that sounds like an Italian name or something. So I'm not surprised that some of the actors, like, may be Italian or foreign or whatever. They find this weird facility in the middle of the woods, and it's got a fence. They immediately just, like, break into the fence. Lights are shining on them, just like automatic lights from this thing. They, like, climb up to the roof and are able to just break open the top thing. And there's, like, a rope that goes down into it. They say it's too cold to stay out there, so, like, they're just trying to get in there and get warm, or at least, you know, have a place to sleep until sunrise. Here's an example of weird writing. Like, it's not all bad acting. Some of it's, like, bad writing. Here's an example. One guy says to Tara Reid, "What's the matter? You scared, little sister?" And she says, "That's big sister to you." And I was like, what the fuck does that mean? You didn't even set any of that shit up. Like, okay, now we know that you're siblings, but what is "that's big sister to you" mean? If he says, whatever, it's whatever. Tara Reid goes the first down the hole. She starts looking around for the light switches and shit. She finds some dead bodies, and instead of screaming, she's just like, what? What is this? Both of the bodies were the two scientist people. One of them's got the screwdriver in the eye, and the other one's dead from something else. The brother comes down because he's looking for her, because he was like, oh, I hadn't heard from her in a while, so he goes down there and starts searching for her. There's like, really cheap jump scares in this, and the second time happens right at this moment where her brother finds her, or she finds him, and it's just like, oh, it's just you. Hey, little big sister. Tara says, you gotta see this. Instead of being like, I found fucking dead bodies, we need to go, she's like, come look at this shit. One of the group's girlfriend characters just decides to walk away. Instead of going in and staying with the group, she just walks away from the whole thing. Don't know where she's going, don't know anything. Everybody else is in there with the weird shit. They all manage to find Bad Deadpool guy in some weird chamber. Like, what is that thing? The door's locked. What is this? He's hooked up to stuff. He's in a weird chair. Bad Deadpool guy's got tubes in his chest, in his stomach, all over his body. He's got a metal collar on. He won't open his eyes. He's got a weird, like, carving in his forehead. Looks like a weird eye. One of the guys finds a key in one of the dead woman's mouth, pulls it out, gets the key. She apparently tried to swallow it so nobody would let the dude out or whatever. The lights are shutting off, so one of the guys is like, there's fuses in the basement. Well, let's go find them. Like, how did you know fuses were in the basement? One of them is like, I know what this key goes to immediately. So they go up to the roof or whatever it is. Apparently that's the key that unlocks the chamber to bad Deadpool fucker. And then one of them's like, I recognize this guy. He was the guy that bit his tongue off and killed his whole family. They manage to turn on the lights, and there's some a different crazy scientist guy who's there, and he's in the basement, and he just starts fucking stabbing the shit out of one of those motherfuckers. They manage to, like, lock him out of whatever room they're in. Then there's a whole bunch of Tara Reid, you know, acting, her, you know, she's crying, oh, brother, oh, my brother, oh, brother. Just so we know, you know, we make sure that we know that that was her brother. Tara's able to find some VHS tapes of scientists talking about the experiments that they're doing. She finds out that they were, like, you know, like, just putting this guy, like, under their, you know, like, making him unconscious, but, like, using his mind to do things. So she goes upstairs and finds bad Deadpool guy, and she sits there, and she's like, talks to the other person, they were doing these things. He was able to, like, astral project. They never say astral project, but that's basically what it is. She says, when I was younger, me and my brother, like, had a thing where we'd be able to, like, escape our bodies. And if you were in prison and solitary and that kind of shit, wouldn't you want to escape your body? So he learned how to be good at, like, escaping his body. And she's like, his mother used to scour his tongue with a wire brush. So we get, like, a kind of a cool, creepy flashback to the kid and his mother, like, doing that, and then, like, the kid's, like, spitting out blood into water or whatever. One of them is named Peter, and Peter's in the basement. And they go down to try and find Peter. That same scientist guy that killed the brother dude is there, and he's got a nail gun. He tries to shoot him, but then he ends up shooting himself in the head with the nail gun. So Peter guy starts attacking all of them, and they run away, and he's chasing them. Holly, fucking girl Holly, locks herself in the chamber, and all of them join her in the chamber, lock themselves in. Peter shows up, and he wants to get him, but he can't get him. But we see him, like, bite his tongue, and his mouth starts bleeding. He takes the blood, and he fucking makes a fucking, you know, one of those weird eyeball things on his head with the blood. So if you fall asleep, the killer guy can, like, get in your body and make you do crazy shit and, like, kill people. So don't fall asleep, because then astral projection bad Deadpool will get in your brain and get you. They decide they're gonna take Holly or whatever her name is and, like, make her fall asleep so that they can, like, trap him in her body or some shit. I don't know. This movie is boring as fuck. I don't remember exactly what was going on. So they know that when she falls asleep, she's gonna get taken over, but she'll be tied up. So they got her. Or him. They got fucking bad Deadpool guy. So she falls asleep, gets taken over. She wakes up. She starts biting the fucking guy. They put a bag on her head and kill her. One of the dudes takes off the bad Deadpool's metal collar thing, rips out all the tubes, I guess assuming that he will die without them. They're going to take out Peter. They get there and they bash Peter with a hammer. Bad Deadpool drops down from the ceiling and snaps fucking dude's neck. She ties a rope to a thing, tries to toss it up the place that they came down, fails. She tries again, it fails. Fucking bad Deadpool guy's, like, walking toward her trying to get her, like, I'm coming for you, I'm coming to get you. She makes him think that she has climbed up the rope, so he starts climbing up the rope. She was not actually up there, she was down there, so she grabs the rope and fucking yanks it down, so he falls down and he's like, blah! And while he's laying there, he's like, kill me, please kill me. So she takes the rope and strangles him to death. She's exhausted from the experience, so she falls asleep. When she wakes up, she's in bed, and everything's nice. And then she starts having, like, weird, like, moaning. She starts feeling, you know, good, and she's in bed, and, like, there's something in bed with her that's giving her those feelings and pleasures. And then he fucking killer dude, bad Deadpool, he pops out of the sheets, and it's fucking him. He was fucking, he was there, he was doing that shit. It's a dream sequence nightmare. But then she wakes up normal again, and the cops come to the facility and they find her. The lady from earlier that had left them is there. Apparently she went and got the cops to bring him back. One of the cops is asking Tara Reid questions, and she won't say anything. And he's like, what's the matter, girl? Cat got your tongue? And they make a big deal about tongues, because he bit the tongues off, and they're all biting tongues off and bleeding at the mouth and whatever. And then Tara Reid looks at the camera with the weird, crazy eyes that guy had. It's kind of like Michael Jackson's Thriller. Kind of ends that way. And that's the movie. That's the whole movie. The sets look really nice. The internal sets and the way they set everything up is really, really good. Even the external stuff, like, they put a lot of effort into that stuff. The sound seems basically fine, except for that weird ADR stuff at the beginning with the weird foreign accents and stuff. The acting is bad, but it might be possibly because of the writing or directing. Sometimes they say things multiple times that don't quite make sense. The story has merit. The story has potential. It just wasn't really executed very well. I mean, they tried. It just, low budget, weird writing script or whatever. The lighting and editing are kind of frustrating. The editing sometimes is very choppy, and like the flashing of the lights is very off-putting and like kind of just hard to look at. This is like a straight to Redbox type movie. It's not bottom of the barrel, but it is a don't recommend from me. So not the best thing I've seen in a while, but I mean, it's not terrible. You could watch it. I don't think you need to. Happy spooky season, everyone. Peace out, guys. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you're thinking and feeling, and hope you enjoyed this, and I'll catch you next time. Let's see if I can just make it a pile on my head. They call me Pilehead. You want to know how I got this hair? I can actually see through that little spot. Happy spooky season! Everybody drink 9 times! And there it goes. But a bunch of that shit's still fucking hanging on my face. Yeah, it's all over. It's all fucking over. Let's see if I can do one of these. I'm a homeless Sasquatch. Somebody take me. What about? Oh, I whip my hair back and forth. I whip my hair back and forth. I think I've become a curmudgeon. Watch this shit. Mep. Make an eyeball on my forehead so I can astral project my way out of this bullshit. This week, Anya Camilleri. She. I'm gonna get beer in my fucking wig hairs. This isn't even a wig, by the way. This is like pieces of something. I don't even know what it is. But she takes, she, and they're like, you know, like, I think, we. I hate these fucking things, they're so itchy. one of the